Hey everybody, and welcome to Johnson Outdoors. My name is Chris Johnson, and today the video that we're going to be doing is just a recap of my entire 2016-2017 season. Hunted hard all season, and unfortunately for me, I was only able to get my hands on one deer. But, you know, had a ton of great experiences, a ton of good bucks, young bucks on camera. So, just going to go through everything and show you pretty much all the bucks I had on camera that were coming to my WinPro mock scrape, and the one deer that I was able to take to get some meat in the freezer. Hope you all enjoy. As you can see, my luck hasn't exactly been the greatest. I mean, I missed that buck chasing that doe not even 45 minutes later. And I remember that day vividly. You know, I got stuck in traffic, wasn't able to get to my spot, but hey, that's just part of it. That's why they call it hunting, not killing. But finally, November 6th, I got my chance. Well, here he is. Little button buck. Thought he was a doe, but I'll take it. Meat in the freezer, and I got my antlerless tag filled. And, you know, first year I've gotten on film that I was able to take. So, all in all, it's been a great day. I couldn't be happier. I can't thank the Lord enough. As excited as I was and as happy as I was that I was able to get some meat in the freezer, it ended up being a bittersweet day for me because no sooner did I drag that button buck out, I looked on the side of the road and there's my number one hitless buck laying in the ditch. It's just part of it. It's things you have to deal with, but he had gotten hit that morning, it turns out. Saw everything seemed fresh. He was a little stiff, but blood was still wet on him. So, I mean, I called up Illinois DNR, got my salvage tag, so at least he's going to get the respect he deserves. I mean, a buck like that was just phenomenal. But, again, you know, there's more of them out there. I wasn't discouraged. I was determined to keep on hunting. They say one mature buck gets knocked out and another moves right in. And here's another number one on my hit list. Never saw him hit that Wimpro mock scrape just right, but I guess he didn't read my script. Thanksgiving morning, my family flew up from Florida, and I wanted to show my dad where I'd been hunting and how the Wimpro system was working. But as you can see, we noticed Big Man had hit that scrape that night before. So we decided to add a little bit more Wimpro dough to it and get him fired up even more. Well, as luck would have it, we're sitting in the ground blind and not even 100 yards away. This big buck comes by and decides to say hi to our camera, where we set up exactly where we were planning to originally set up the ground blind. But we found fresher signs, so we set up on the other side. Once again, that's why they call it hunting. Thank you. then we saw a monstrous coyote. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get it on film, but it kind of woke the predator bug in me. So I gave my buddy Doug a call out in Indiana, and he said he's been having coyotes come up to his horse pasture and jack with his horses. So we figured we'd go out there and help him out a little bit.
Behind him kind of makes me wonder if there's not another one back in the woods.
He's looking over here though, slowly. God, he's a pretty dog.
Can you get any stills of him?
Yeah, I took a couple. Getting video
over
right
here
now.
See if you can get. Oh, there he goes.
This must be Antonio Brown. Is this
hanging
up to your
car? Yeah. There you go. This is another
sack. Oh, is that her? She's jacked. They're all sack brothers. Same sack mother. Every time she snapped, makes you a pretzel's all day. Look at those ears sticking straight up.
Oh. Turning away.
But unfortunately for us, just like my luck the rest of the season, we couldn't get the coyotes to come on the other side of the fence where we were allowed to shoot them. We had to just kind of sit and watch. Well, with a couple weeks being left in the season, I figured I'd head back and try my hand at getting a late season buck.
Well, it's been a good season. There's a guy not even 50 yards behind me, set up in a tree stand. I can't fault him for trying to be successful this season, but come on, man. He walked right by my blind. Guess that's a testament to how good this blind's brushed in. You know, I've been successful this season, so I can't complain. And I can't fault somebody for trying to have some last minute success. So, I'm gonna pack up, grab my camera, get it out of here, and call it. It's been a great year, great season. Learned a lot here in Illinois for the 2016-2017 season. And there's some very good young bucks I got on camera. So hopefully next year I'll be on them. And next year will be my year.
I may look like a city slicker, shining up through my shoes. Underneath I'm just a cotton picker, picking out a mess of blues. Show me where I start, find a horse and cart. I'm just a country boy at heart.
Well guys, I just want to say thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking with me through this season. I know it's been a rough one, but hopefully next year I'll have more shots and more kills for you. Turkey season is coming up soon, so hopefully I'll be able to get some more footage of that for you. Until next time, I'm Chris Johnson. Thanks for watching.